Dear learners, welcome to Certificate in Arabic Language online lectures. I am Dr. Muhammad Salim, Assistant Professor Arabic, School of Foreign Languages, Indira Gandhi National Open University. Dear learners, you are learning some of the most fascinating expressions in Arabic, some of the most commonly used Arabic sentences and expressions that you can use in everyday life situations. So learners, you see, here we are giving you, we have selected very carefully some of the most commonly used expressions. So each expression is important, so try to practice as much as possible. Okay, so now we start with the first important Arabic expression for today's lecture, and it is hal yumkinuni. I am saying this, try to follow the voice. Hal yumkinuni an as'aluka ya ustazi. It's certainly a long sentence. Please don't be scared with the long. It's a long sentence, but it's not very difficult. I will explain a little bit. Hal, you are very much familiar. Hal, it is interrogative. You ask the question with hal, hal. Okay, in Arabic, yumkinuni, this kind of expression, you have already done it. Yumkinuni. So hal yumkin. Yumkin, many of you speaking Urdu, Hindi, no, mumkin, mumkin, mumkin is possible, possible, okay. So, hal yumkinuni, is it possible for me, is it possible for me, an as'aluka, as'aluka, that I can ask a question, ya, means, oh, ustaz, is teacher, okay. So, it's, can we say this, can I ask you, my teacher? Oh, my teacher, okay, can I ask you a question, okay, suppose a student is requesting the teacher, hal yumkinuni, is it possible for me, and as aluka, that I ask a question, ya ustazi, oh my teacher, okay. So this is, certainly it is a long sentence, but if you break it up, and you will really get the meaning, okay, there is no difficulty at all. So try to practice it with me. Hal yumkinuni an as'aluka ya ustazi. Can I ask you, oh my teacher? This is exact, okay, expression. So dear learners, now we are moving to the next one. And when a student is asking, okay, the teacher, and the teacher is responding this way, naam tafazzal, naam. Naam tafaddal. What does it mean? Naam tafaddal. Naam means yes, tafaddal, come on, miss. I am ready to respond to or reply to the question that you will ask. So, come on. Okay, naam tafaddal. Tafaddal. This is the expression. See the Arabic here from naam, this, and tafaddal. It's what? This is not dal, not za, no. This difference between, so sounds, you have to be very careful in selecting, pronouncing the word. Naham tafaddal. Naham tafaddal means yes, come on. As if teacher is ready to reply the question. Okay. So naham tafaddal. Okay. Practice it as many times as you can. Now moving on to the next one. Next Arabic expression, and that is من أين؟ من أين تعلمت اللغة العربية؟ من أين تعلمت اللغة العربية؟ What is this؟ من أين؟ من from أين؟ Where؟ تعلمت, you have learned اللغة, لغة, it's language, العربية is Arabic, okay. So من أين؟ From where؟ تعلمت, you have learned اللغة العربية, Arabic language, okay. So from where, you have learned Arabic language, okay. This means من أين تعلمت اللغة العربية؟ Okay, this is the question you quite often ask your friend, your colleagues, your teacher even. Okay, من أين تعلمت اللغة العربية؟ Sometimes in English, okay, you want من أين تعلمت اللغة الإنجليزية، اللغة الفرنسية، اللغة الألمانية، اللغة الأردوية، الهندية. Okay, so this way you can ask anyone with this pattern, with this model. من أين تعلمت؟ If you got this pattern, you can use it other at many times, anywhere you want. Okay, so min ayna ta'allamta al-lughah al-arabiyya. This is min ayna, from where you have learned Arabic language. Okay. Now, dear learners, moving on to the next. These are little bit, you know, longer sentences. So don't be, you know, afraid of it, that long sentences will make the learning difficult. Not at all. I'm breaking it up and trying to make it as simple as possible. All right. Now, moving on to the next. من أين تعلمت اللغة العربية? This is a question. من أين? أين? From where you have learned. Okay. So the answer will be, of course, تعلمت. Means I have learned اللغة العربية. اللغة العربية means Arabic language. من الجامعة الملية الإسلامية. Okay. From جامعة ملية إسلامية. Okay. I'm mentioning the name of the university, that from there I have learned Arabic language. All right. You can say from جامعة إندرا غاندي. Means Indira Gandhi University, from Jamiatul Jawaharlal Nehru, Jamiatul Delhi, Delhi University. You can mention your institution, your college, your university accordingly. Okay. So I have just given, just for the sake of example, I have added this one, Jamia Al Milliya. تعلمت اللغة العربية من الجامعة الملية الإسلامية. All right. So now moving on to the next expression, and here. It's like a dialogue, you know, dialogue form, you know, asking the question and then answer. Question and answer. Okay. حل الجامعة الملية. حل. Again, حل. What is حل? حل. This is for the sake of asking question. You use this word حل. حل الجامعة. جامعة الملية. قريبة. قريبة. Okay. حل الجامعة. جامعة is university, of course. Okay. جامعة. So, الجامعة الملية. Is Jamia Millia nearby? Okay. You are saying قريبةً and بعيدةً. It's opposite is بعيد. بعيد means far. Okay. So the question is, هل الجامعة الملية قريبةً? Is Jamia Millia nearby? And the answer is نعم. نعم is again yes. لا is no. نعم is yes in Arabic. نعم هي قريبة من بيتي. قريبة. قاف. And the sound will be, it's not kaf, kariba, no. Qariba, this is here. Qaf. Qariba. Naam, hiya qaribatun min bayti. Qaribatun min bayti. Yes, it is near my house. Okay, that is what you are saying. Yes, it is near my house. Naam, hiya qaribatun min bayti. Alright. Now, moving on to the next expression. Another very common and frequently used Arabic expression I am giving you, never forget it. You will lose if you forget, because fakir fil amr, fakir fil amr. Okay, what is fakir? Many of you speaking Urdu and Hindi, of course, may be aware of the word fikr. Is what is fikr? Thought. Fikra is thought. Fikr, thinking. So fakir is think. It's Arabic word, of course, originally Arabic word. We are using it, okay, quite often in our own language. So, fakir fil amr. Fakir. What is? Think about it. Think about it. Okay. You ask your colleague, your friend, while you have some deliberation on a certain important issues, you quite often ask them to say like this: fakir fil amr. Think about it. Think about it. Okay. Next one is, dear learners, hada lutfum minka. Lutf. What is lutf? Lam, ta, fa, lutf, minka. There should be a difference between ta and ta. So you should always be careful while using this. Hada lutfun minka. Hada lutfun minka. What does it mean? Does it mean? Hada lutfun minka. It's a kind of you. You know? It's up. Because of your kindness, it is happening. All right. It's because of your kindness it's happening. It's complimentary. It's like you complimenting somebody. Okay. Hada lutfun minka. It's because of you, your mercy that all that is happening. Okay. Good things are happening. Okay. So hada lutfun minka. Okay. It's because of you. Okay. It's a kind of you. All right. So it's very free. Common expression, please try to remember it. All right. Now moving on to the next one, and the next one is havin alaika. Listen, ha, the sound is ha from this here, this portion, ha, and havin alaika. What does it mean, havin alaika? Okay, hawwin alayka. In English you say take it easy, take it easy. Okay, most of the time people get stressed, you know, and they get, you know, nervous about certain things. So you try to calm down the person by saying take it easy. It isn't in English, okay? Take it easy, take it easy. Don't be much burdened and stressed about the thing that you are having in mind. So in English, in Arabic also we have similarly hawwin alayka. What? Hawwin, hawwin alayka, hawwin alayka, hawwin alayka. Okay, in case the person happens to be a female, if she is a lady and you are consoling her, you are asking her to calm down, okay, or take it easy, so you will say hawwin alayki, hawwin alayki. Instead of ka, it will be ki, hawwin alayki. That is the only difference. Otherwise this expression remains same, hawwin alayki. Now dear learners, moving on to the next one. Next expression is khuz waqtaka, khuz waqtaka. No, it's not ta, it is ta. Wa, waw, qaf, ta. Waqtaka, waqtaka, waqtaka. Okay, khud, waqtaka. Khud. What is khud? Akhada, root word is, root word is alif, hamza, kha, dal, akhada. Akhada means take. Akhada means akhada, and khud. Khud means take. You are requesting somebody, you are requesting or asking somebody, khud, take. What take? Waqtaka, waqtaka, take your time. Take your time. It's a literal, you know, take your time, isn't it? Most of the time you ask somebody who is, you know, whom you want to complete certain work, you just say take your time, okay? It's be not in a hurry, and you can take your time, you can, you know, do it the way you want. So in Arabic the same expression is khuz waqtaka, khuz waqtaka. All right. So I think, dear learners, it's increasingly becoming exciting for you to learn the language by learning these common Arabic expressions, and these are really wonderful and fascinating to know these, you know, expressions, because through the help of these sentences, expressions, you are able to communicate in daily life situation. All right, now moving on to the next one. لا تتردد في الاتصال بي. لا تتردد. What is تتردد? تردد. Taraddud is taraddud, hesitation, hesitation. Okay, taraddud in Arabic, hesitation is taraddud. Okay, fi means in. Al ittisal is wasl, wasl word. Many of people familiar with Urdu might be using the word wasl. Wasl means connection, connection. Il ittisal bi, connecting, connecting, connecting me. Okay, so what is the meaning in fact? La tataraddud fi ittisal bi, la tataraddud fi ittisal bi. What does it mean? Now finally, don't hesitate to call me. Okay, don't hesitate to call me. Most of the time, in fact, you when you talk to your customer, your client, your person, or anybody in fact who want you to be familiar with, don't hesitate to call me. Okay, in Arabic also, in the same fashion, we have لا تتردد في الاتصال بي. لا تتردد, لا تتردد في الاتصال بي. All right. So dear learners, we are moving, all right, moving without any problem. All these common expressions you are learning, and I hope you are enjoying it, because these are very common and you need all these sentences for communication. Now comes the practice. Okay, the same kind of expressions I will help you practice in Arabic. I will not mention English version so that you can check your progress. If you are not able to even properly understand it, you can go back to the earlier slide and try to find the meaning from there. I will not give you the meaning. You have to work hard, otherwise you will relax and stop learning. All right, so apply your mind and learn. I am starting the practice one, and Arabic version I will read and try to find meaning by yourself. Ana طالب, أنا طالب في جامعة إندرا غاندي الوطنية المفتوحة. Okay, أنا طالب, this is something you are familiar with, no issue. في جامعة, that is again, جامعة is university, إندرا غاندي الوطنية المفتوحة, that I will explain certainly, because this is new, this is something I have not explained to you. So إندرا غاندي, National Open University. Okay, in Arabic how you say جامعة إندرا غاندي الوطنية المفتوحة. Okay. Now moving to the next. هل يمكنني؟ هل يمكنني؟ It's little bit difficult, but yes, with practice you can master this. All these. هل يمكنني أن أسألك؟ أن أسألك؟ أسألك يا أستاذي؟ يا أستاذي. هل يمكنني أن أسألك يا أستاذي؟ A little bit difficult, I believe, for you to say it, but try to practice. As you practice, you can master. هل يمكنني أن أسألك يا أستاذي؟ Okay. And the answer is نعم. تفضل. Then من أين تعلمت اللغة العربية؟ من أين تعلمت اللغة العربية؟ تعلمت اللغة العربية من جامعة إندرا غاندي الوطنية المفتوح. ما شاء الله. Okay, ما شاء الله. It's a kind of compliment, you know. Most of the time, when somebody is doing something good, you say ما شاء الله. Okay, may God increase it. Okay. Now next one is عملٌ رائع. Miss, this is good work. Okay, commendable work. هل الجامعة هل؟ It's not ها, it is her. هل الجامعة قريبة؟ هل الجامعة قريبة؟ نعم هي قريبة. نعم هي قريبة. هذا لطف منك. هذا لطف منك. Next is حظ عليك. And next is خذ وقتك. Okay. So dear learners, you have got so many plenty of expressions, you know, and these expressions are to some extent related to each other. If you really listen to this video time and again, you will certainly be able to speak the language without any problem. All right. Now I am coming to the practice 2, part 2, where I will just mention English expressions and you have to find the Arabic one. Okay. It is your duty to search. Okay. And it is your job. Now I will not help you much because here you have to apply your mind and check your progress. I am a student of Jamia. Okay, what does it mean? Okay, you can check it. You can go back to the earlier slide and try to find out, because you have to work little bit, okay, so that you are able to master the, you are able to learn the language. So I am not mentioning Arabic one. I am a student of Jamia. That is the expression. Say it in Arabic. I am moving to the next one. Can I ask a question? Now, yes, come on. Okay. Try to say it in Arabic. I am not repeating Arabic version because I believe you have already got it. Now you have to practice only. Where did you learn your Arabic from? This expression you have already got in Arabic. Try to repeat it. Where did you learn your Arabic from? I learned Arabic from IGNU. Very good. Okay. Is this university near your house? Yes, it is near my house. Learn your lessons and enjoy your study. Take it easy. All right. So all these expressions are very simple and common, and I have helped you. In fact, do all these expressions in Arabic as well. So all that is present there. I need not repeat the Arabic version again. You just try to check your progress by reading all these or listening to all these and then giving Arabic version. It's better to have your colleague, your friend, your okay, brother, anybody in fact who is interested and passionate to learn the language, to have beside you and try to in fact interact with you. Use these expressions and talk to the person as much as possible, possibly on a cup of tea. Okay, that will be really more exciting for you. Now dear learners, moving to the practice third, part third, and here I will certainly give you some more common expressions, but they remain same almost, and I will add a few of them. Wherever I will add, I will explain it. Otherwise, I will leave it up to you to decide and to check your progress. All right. So now it is Arabic. Jamihatu, Jamihatu, Indira Ghadi. Jamihatu, in English, in Arabic. Jamihatu, Indira Ghadi. Jamihatun Shahira. Jamihatun Shahira. Jamihatu, Indira Ghadi. Jamihatun Shahira. Hadihi, Jamihatun, Wataniya, Wataniya. Wataniya. What is Wataniya means? This is something I have added. Okay, Watan is nation. This is a national university. It means this is a national university. Okay. Hadihi, Jamiatun Wataniya. Wataniya. Watan is a nation. And Wataniya is national university. Taqaw hadihi al-jamia fil Hind. Taqaw means it is present. It is present. This university is present in India. Okay. This is in India. Means it is an Indian university. That is what we are saying. Okay. Taqaw hadhihi al-jami'a fil Hind. Now moving on to the next one. Ana talib fi hadhihi al-jami'a. Ana talib fi hadhihi al-jami'a. What does it mean? Ana talib, you know it. Ana talib. Ana talib, I am a student. Ana talib fi hadhihi al-jami'a. In this university. In this university, I am a student. Means I am a student of this university. Okay, ana talib. And if the person is female, suppose female is saying ana talib, so she will say ana talibatun, talibatun, not talib, ana taliba, taliba, taliba fi hadhihi al-jami'a. I am a student of this university. I am a student of this university. That's okay. So dear learners, this way you can introduce yourself, you can use this expression ana talib fi hadhihi al-jami'a, ana talib fi jami'ati Indira Gandhi. Okay, this way. Now dear learners, I am moving to the next important Arabic expression, and that is uridu an as'ala shay'an. What does it mean? Uridu means I want, and as'ala is from sual is question. As'ala shay'an. So uridu means ana uridu, I want to ask something. I want to ask something. Okay, that is the expression in Arabic. Uridu an as'ala shay'an. Uridu an as'ala shay'an. Okay, now next one. Hal yumkinu li an as'ala. Can I ask? Okay. Most of the time you seek permission of the person, suppose teacher, suppose mentor, suppose a great person. You just cannot go and just ask the question, okay, without permission. It's not a good habit, in fact, to ask great people, in fact, this way. So you just ask, you know, request first. Before asking the question, you request the person, hal yumkinu li, may I ask an as'ala question? May I ask the question? Yeah, can I ask the question? Okay. Now the next, naham, tafaddal. Naham, yes, come on. The person is very generous. He wants to take your question and just is saying, yes, come on, ask the question. Okay, I'm ready to answer. So, hal yumkin li an as'ala? And now the reply came, naham, tafaddal. Okay. Now, dear learners, we are moving very fast, but also at the same time, I hope there is learning, and you are learning it, you know, with a lot of into and interest. Next one is سَمِعْتُ أَنَّ هَذِهِ الْجَامِعَةَ جَامِعَةٌ مَرْكَزِيَةٌ. It is a little bit long sentence, but I have heard that this university is a central university. This university is central university. Okay, سَمِعْتُ أَنَّ هَذِهِ الْجَامِعَةَ جَامِعَةٌ مَرْكَزِيَّةٌ. I have heard this university is central university. Okay, so this is a little bit a long sentence, but really, you know, it's useful. You can use while, you know, having conversation with somebody. This is a very common expression. Okay, now next one, نَحَمْ. Naham. Again, naham is yes. Okay, naham. Here, jamihatun markaziyya. Yes. it is a central university. It is a central university. No, I quit, no doubt. It is a central university. Central University. Okay. And now the next, Shukran Jazila. What does it mean? Shukran, Shukriya. Shukriya word that you use most of the time. It's Arabic word. Shukriya means thank you. Thank you. In Arabic we say Shukran. And Shukran Jazila is thank you very much. Alright. So, dear learners, you have practiced these common important Arabic expressions, and you are now able to, with the help of these expressions, you are able to communicate in daily life situations without much difficulty, I believe. Because you can repeat all these expressions, you can listen it several times, you will be able to gain further confidence in your Arabic language learning. But before I close, I would like you to repeat once again with me. Say the way I am saying all these expressions. So just repeat with me. This time I will not translate all these. Okay, I will just be a little bit slow, and you have to follow each and every word properly. All right, with proper pronunciation, because pronunciation in Arabic is really very important. Otherwise, you will give your wrong meaning. Okay, bad pronunciation will lead to a wrong meaning. That will confuse the listener. So be very particular, very, very careful in using the Arabic words. All right. So now, for the sake of practice, I am just repeating once again. Try to follow me. Okay. Jamihatu, Jamihatu, Indira Gandhi, Jamihatun Shahiratun, or Jamiha Shahira. You need not say Tanmeen with Tuntun, no. Jamiha Shahira. So Jamihatu Indira Gandhi Jamiha Shahira. Okay. Hadihi Jamihatun Wataniya. Wataniya. Or Hadihi Jamiha Wataniya. Without tun. Okay. Hadihi Jamiha Wataniya. Taqaw. It's not ta, it is ta. Ta sound is this ta. Ta qa qaw qaf sound qaf. Ta qaw. This is little bit difficult because several difficult words letters you have here. Ta qaw ta qaw ta qaw. Hadhihi al jamiha tu fil hind. Ta qaw hadhihi al jamiha tu fil hind. Fil hind. Ana talib or ana talibun or for female. أنا طالبة في هذه الجامعة في هذه الجامعة أريد أن أسأل شيئا أريد أن أسأل شيئا هل يمكن لي أن أسأل هل يمكن لي أن أسأل and نعم تفضل نعم تفضل سمعت أن هذه الجامعة جامعة مركزية or جامعة مركزية سمعت أن هذه الجامعة جامعة مركزية نعم هي جامعة مركزية or نعم هي جامعة مركزية شكرا جزيلا شكرا جزيلا so dear learners now you have learned some of the most important and fascinating Arabic expressions, and these expressions will help you not only learn the language but also communicate in daily life situations, and with the help of these you can communicate with your friends, with your family members, with your colleagues, with your relatives, with anybody who is interested in this language, all right, and who is able to or passionate to learn the language. It will be a really exciting experience for you to learn this language and enjoy this language. So thank you very much. Shukran jazila. Ma'assalama. Bye bye.